Laura's family have been absolutely brilliant in the work they've put into everything and in the detail they've put in, from the numbers on your tables to the sign telling you where to park to absolutely fantastic. So we've got a couple little gifts for them, so I'm just going to put my big speech down there and grab these and I'll pass them over. So what we've got here, some flowers. They were discreetly hidden from them. And we've got you. So these are so everyone, please. Some beautiful things as well, so discreetly hidden behind them again. Some beautiful flowers passed to my mother. Equally beautiful. Right.
You're welcome.
That gives him a lot of things that you need to be a best man. But first, it's great to see one turn up on time. She's fantastic, he's been full stop, isn't he? At the moment. But he's got all the attributes that you need. He likes sitting around eating. He loves donuts. Also, he likes the drunken disorder. So give it a few hours, he's going to see some of you out. He also does night shifts. Right. So, Simon. You're lucky, you get a gift as well. This is what you need. This is yours. Now, there you go, let's have a cheer for someone. There's only one person in this room more special than Sai and Laura. Not as if, not obviously not as important as Laura, but there's a little star. There is a star in the making.
Yeah.
This little one over here, Harry Goldsmith.
Laura. To Laura.
formalities, I suppose. So, for those of you that don't know me, my name's Simon, and Rob and I are old school friends. I would like to start by thanking Laura and Charlotte for what a fantastic day you've planned here today, because I know Rob had literally nothing to do with it. To give you a little insight there, Rob told me about two jobs he had to do. One was to tell me when the rehearsal was, which he told me the day before. And one was to give me the tie that I'm wearing now, which he forgot to bring to the rehearsal. That gives you a little insight into Rob's world there. But Laura, Charlotte, thank you very much. You've done an excellent job here today. And also, like I say, bridesmaids, you all look wonderful.
Yeah.
Absolutely fantastic. Eclipsed by Laura, Laura, you look absolutely stunning, I'm sure. It's great to see that everyone's enjoying themselves. Now, as best man, you kind of get a little bit of behind the scenes, and I can tell you, it's not all been roses today. There's been tears, there's been mascara everywhere, and that's just Rob. He promised me he wouldn't cry. And he did really, really well. I could see it building, but you held on, brother, you held on. So, some of you think it's the easiest thing in the world to write a speech about Rob. And when he asked me, I thought, that's nailed on, no problem at all. Until you start to think about some of the things that Rob has done, and how appropriate they are for a wedding setting. Yeah. So it's not really been as easy as perhaps I hoped it would be. So I thought maybe what I should do is have a theme for this speech. And there was one burning question, after really deep thoughts about this, one burning question that I kept coming back to. And that question, as I'm sure you all agree, is why marry Rob? So I had to think about it, and I had to think about that long, long and hard. And then I thought maybe it's because of Rob's thoughtfulness. Because he does. He spends a lot of time thinking about his friends and his family and himself. Sometimes he gets up in the morning, he literally doesn't stop thinking about people until he opens his mouth. And then I thought, well, maybe it's not just Rob's thoughtfulness, but also Rob's sporting prowess. Now, some of you may not know this, but when Rob and I left school, Rob was mentioned because of the contribution he'd made to the school football team. He wasn't in it. But it's not just his sporting prowess, Rob is also very academically gifted. Because Rob and I went through school together, we went through college together, we did our A-levels together, and Rob achieved no less than 3 E's at A-level. Thankfully, was good enough to get him into a university that would basically accept anyone. Sorry, I think. Yes. So, another reason might be that Rob is a very caring person. He does care a lot about his appearance. I'm sure you all agree he's looking pretty good today. He's rocked up pretty well. He's an image conscious sort of a guy. I remember once him telling me that there were 3 forms of entertainment that he likes the most. It was football, TV and mirrors. So, why marry Rob? I can only come to the conclusion that opposites attract. So, if the theme of my speech had been, why marry Laura, it would have been much, much easier. Because Laura's beautiful, she's funny, all the things that Rob isn't. She has the patience of a saint. I don't really know that. I assume she must have it. And she accepts you for who you are. She loves you for who you are. despite all of your recent health problems, many of which have turned out to be fictitious. Thankfully, you are here today. And at one point, you had actually made plans for this thing awake rather than a wedding. But you are here today, and we're all here to share this moment with you. Now, raising a glass and a toast to these guys, I don't think is enough. So what I would like you to do is leave your glasses on the table, please stand up, and a nice big round of applause and cheer for Mr. and Mrs. Goldsmith. Yeah.